ओके, सो वी हैव कवर्ड फर्स्ट मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया, सेकेंड मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया, पोलार मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया एंड रेडियस ऑफ गायरेशन. फर्स्ट मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया इज नथिंग बट द, इट कैन बी अप्लाइड टू द टर्म ऑफ मास एंड इट कैन बी अप्लाइड टू द टर्म ऑफ एरिया. ओके, सो इट्स द फर्स्ट मोमेंट ऑफ एरिया इफ यू कंसिडर, इट इज ए इंटू x. x is nothing but the perpendicular distance from the center of gravity of the area to the reference axis about which you are going to calculate the area moment of inertia. Okay, so it will be having the unit of mm cube, because area has unit of mm square and distance has unit of mm, so mm cube. And second moment of inertia is nothing but the area into that distance, that there will be the square of the distance, so that's why a into x square, so that's why it will be mm raised to 4, because area is in mm square and distance is will be in mm, but we have the square of the distance, so that's why mm square, so mm square into mm square, that will be mm raised to 4. Polar moment of inertia is nothing but the addition of ixx and iyy. So that's why it will be also having unit mm raised to 4. Fourth point is the radius of gyration. Okay, so for the radius of gyration, k, that is equal to root of I by A. So I has unit of mm raised to 4, isn't it? So it is mm raised to 4 divided by mm square. It will be root of mm square. That will be nothing but mm. Okay, so the radius of gyration will have unit mm. Okay, so actually we have gone through of all this concept, but I didn't tell you about this unit. So that's why first moment of inertia will be having unit of mm cube. Second moment of inertia will be having unit of mm raised to 4. Polar moment of inertia will be having also unit of mm raised to 4. And radius of gyration will have unit of mm. So now here we have a problem. That is, this is the T section having dimension 10 into 2. Okay, so we have to find the moment of inertia about their centroidal axis, horizontal axis and vertical axis, and also we have to find out the polar moment of inertia. Okay, so this axis, this image or this section is symmetrical about y axis. Okay, what is the meaning of symmetry? Means if I divide this along this y axis, then on the both sides it will have same area, so this is symmetrical about y axis. About xx axis it is not symmetrical, so we need to determine its location of horizontal axis, centroidal horizontal axis. Okay, so for that let us consider this is first area and this one is the second area. So this is the another, this is the separate part and this is the separate part. Okay, so we know that x bar is equal to 5 cm, because 10 divided by 2 from this, if you are calculating from this x as a reference, then it is at a distance of 5 cm from this origin. Now along y axis, okay, so we have to locate the y bar. So we have used the formula. We use the formula that is nothing but a1 multiplied by y1 plus a2 multiplied by y2 divided by a1 plus a2. Okay, so this is the formula which we use always. So here a1 into y1 is a number of moment of inertia. So as I have already explained to you, first moment of inertia, I have already explained to you that for calculation of the center of gravity we use first moment of area theorem. Okay, so this is here. So a1 multiplied by y1. So a1, so this is the first area we have considered. A1 is nothing but a 10 into 2 into y1. So it will be the center of gravity of this section, isn't it? So it is located at a distance of 2 divided by 2, that is nothing but 1, and this 8 plus 1 is nothing but 9. So it is, its centroidal axis is from this axis, it is located at distance of 9 centimeters. Okay, plus second area, that is the second section, that is nothing but 8 into 2, and it is located at a distance of 4 centimeters from this reference axis. So 8 into 2 into 4. Okay, now at the new denominator, that is a1 plus a2, so that is equal to 10 into 2 plus 8 into 2. Okay, so 10 into 2 into 9 plus 8 into 2 into 4 divided by 20 plus 16. So this comes out to be 6.777 centimeter. Okay, so this is equal to 6.77 centimeter. So now centroidal location of center of gravity is the location we know, the location of center of gravity, y at 6.77 centimeter from this axis. Okay, so this is y bar, so this is x ox, and again x bar is 5 centimeter. So it is like this. This is yy axis, and this is xx axis. Okay, so we have to find the moment of inertia, or first moment of inertia about, we have to find the second moment of inertia about this xx axis and yy axis. Okay, so now let us find out IXX. Okay, 1, IXX 1 means we have to find out the moment of inertia of this section about XX, isn't it? So this is the centroidal axis of this section, and we want to find out the moment of inertia about this xx axis. Okay, so we have to use parallel axis theorem. So that is nothing but ig plus a into h square. Okay, so what is the moment formula for the moment of inertia about the centroidal axis for a rectangular section? That is nothing but the BD cube by 12 plus A into S square. So here the width is 10 centimeter. So that's why 10 into 2 cube divided by 12 plus A. A is nothing but 10 into 2 into h. What I have told you, that is h is nothing but the distance between centroidal axis of this section, or center of gravity of this section, to the reference axis. Okay, so we are calculating about xx. So that's why we have to find out this distance. Okay, so we know that this distance is 6.77 centimeter. It is known to us. We need to find this. Okay, or this. So how we can determine it? So total height is 8 plus 2, that is nothing but 10. 10 minus 6.77 will give us this, total length or total height. So how we can do that? 10 minus 6.77. This comes out to be 3.23. Okay, 3.23. This is from this point to this top of the section. But we want to find out the distance up to the center of gravity. So we know this is how much. This is nothing but the 1 centimeter. So 3.23 minus 1. Okay, this will give us the exact location of center of gravity of this section from this x-x axis or reference axis. That is nothing but 3.23 minus 1, that comes out to be 2.23. okay, so 2.23 square. So this is 2.23. okay, so by calculating this we got 10 into 2 cube divided by 12 plus 10 into 2 into 2.23 square, that is 106.12 centimeter. Rest to 4, 106.12 centimeter rest to 4, because of all these are unit in centimeter, so that's why it is 106.12 mm rest to centimeter rest to 4. Okay, now xx 22, that is nothing but the center of moment of inertia of this second section about this centroidal axis, xx. Okay, so how to calculate that? We have to use same ig plus as square. That is nothing but the, which theorem we are using? That is nothing but the parallel axis theorem we are using, because this section is not symmetrical about this xx axis, or this center of gravity of this section is different from this reference axis. So that's why we are using the parallel axis theorem. So ig plus a square, we know the formula, bd cube by 12 plus a into h square. Okay, so we know this is the 2 centimeter length plus d, that is nothing but depth, that is nothing but 8 bd cube by 12 plus area, that is 2 into 8 into h. Now the calculation of h. Okay, so this is the section having length of or height of 8 centimeter. Okay, so we want to know the center of gravity of it. It is located at distance of 4 centimeter, like this. Okay, so we want to know the distance between these two points. Okay, this is the center of gravity of the section of which we are going to calculate the moment of inertia, and this is the reference axis about which we have to calculate the moment of inertia. Okay, so this distance, that matters, so that we have to calculate. So 6.77 minus 4 will give us what is the distance between these two reference lines. Okay, so how to do that? 6.77 minus 4. Okay, so it is come out to be 2.77. Okay, so this is 2.77 centimeter. So 2 into 8 into 2.77 77 square. Okay, so after calculating this, we will get the moment of inertia of the second body. So 2 into 8 cube divided by 12 plus 2 into 8 into 2.77 square. Okay, so we got 208.10 centimeter raised to 4. Ix is 1 and Ix is 2. So the moment of inertia of this whole section about Ixx will come out, that is Ixx 1 plus Ixx 2. So that is 106.12 plus 208.10 plus 106.12. Okay, so this is 314.21 centimeter raised to 4. 314.21 centimeter raised to 4. Now we have to calculate IYY. Let us calculate IYY 1. Okay, so you will see that it is symmetrical about YY axis. So we do not need of a parallel axis theorem. Okay, so simply by using the formula, simple formula, you can calculate the moment of inertia. In the first case, when we were calculating the Ixx, it is not symmetrical about x axis. So that's why we need to find out the moment of inertia by using parallel axis theorem. But about YY axis, it is symmetrical. So that's why you can easily calculate the moment of inertia about YY axis by just simple formula, that is nothing but BD cube by 12. Okay, so in this case, about YY axis, we are calculating. So this is the 2 centimeter is width, and D is nothing but this 10 centimeter is the height. We can consider like that. So 2 into 10 cube by 12, and IYY 2, it will be like, this is the length, so 8, and 2 is the height, so 8 into 2 cube divided by 12. So these are the two formulas, simple formulas with that can be used, and we can find out IYY because it is symmetric about YY axis. Okay, so for that, let us calculate 2 into 10 cube divided by 12. Okay, so it's come out to be 166.66 centimeter raised to 4. Then second, 8 into 2 cube divided by 12, that come out to be 8 into 2 cube divided by 12, 8 into 2 cube divided by 12, that comes out to be 5.33. Okay, so that is 5.33 centimeter raised to 4. Okay, so addition of this for calculation of total moment of inertia about IYY axis, that is 166.66 plus 5.33. 171.99 centimeter raised to 4, that is nothing but 172 centimeter raised to 4. So we got Ixx is equal to 314.21 centimeter raised to 4, IYY is equal to 172 centimeter raised to 4. Now we have to find out the polar moment of inertia. Okay, so polar moment of inertia is nothing but the moment of inertia about z axis. So that is nothing but like this. So suppose this is the z axis. Okay, about this we have to calculate the moment of inertia of this whole section. Okay, but we have the proof, that is Ixx plus Iy. If we are adding this both, it will give us the moment of polar moment of inertia. So Izz is equal to Ixx plus Iyy, 314.21 plus 172. Okay, so this is 314.21 plus 172 is equal to 486.21 centimeter raised to 4. Okay, so this is the polar moment of inertia. So we got Ixx and Iyy, okay, and Izz. Like this.